Hello there. On this tutorial, I am going to demonstrate how to lazy load images. That is to load the images until the user scrolls down to it and not on the initial page load. If you see this image tag here, you can see that there isn't anything special about it. It is simply downloading and showing an image color ranking. So as you would expect, the image is going to be downloaded initially as soon as I refresh the browser here. And if I check the network, you can see that the ranking image has been downloaded and nothing special happened as I scroll down to it. So how do I change it so that it won't be downloaded until the user scrolls down to it? Well, to begin with, I'm going to change this src attribute to data-src. The main thing here to keep in mind is to not have the image path on the source attribute, because that will trigger the download. Instead, I place the source value in another attribute, at least temporarily. What should happen now is that the ranking image should not be downloaded, and when I scroll down to it, nothing special happened. We just see the image alt here. I have made the first step to lazy load my image. Now, for the next step, I need to write some JavaScript. I am going to create a new JavaScript file here on my app directory, and I will call it lazyload.js. Here, I will create a lazy load function, which is going to receive target as a parameter. Target is going to be the DOM element that I want to lazy load, and since I'm using EX6 modules, I am going to export it before I forget. And now, let's write the function body. As I explained it on the introduction, I am going to be using the intersection observer, and in order to create a new instance of it, I need to pass it a callback function, which is going to receive the entries being observed and the observer itself. And in order to make this easier to understand, I am going to begin simply by doing a console log of the entries parameters. And I need to actually observe the target that is being passed down to my lazy load function, otherwise it's not going to do anything. Now, I am going to import my lazy load function into my post.js file, and you can see that I already have a query selector here to get the image nodes, which in my case use the CSS selector. And you can see the image, and you can see that the image I'm trying to lazy load is going to be selected by this. Here, a direct child of a DOM element with the class toonWrap, and inside a DOM element with the class single post content. Now, because this query selector is going to return an array, I am going to use the forEach function, and here I am going to say that I want to apply my lazy load function to each of the elements returned by this query selector. Now, I will refresh my browser and let's check the console. You can see that there are four console logs. This is because there's actually four images that match my query selector on this page. You can see some interesting attributes here, but the one I need is this is intersecting, which as you can see right now, it's saying it's false. Now, as I scroll down, you can see that as I get to my image, I am seeing another console log, but this time the is intersecting attribute is true. So we can use this attribute to know when the user is starting to see the image that I want to load. Back at my lazy load function, I will remove the console log, and instead, what I want to do is check the is intersecting attribute. But since intersection observer passed the entries as an array, I need to use a forEach on the entries. And here, I will check if the entry is intersecting. So once I'm here, I know it's because my target is now on the viewport, or in other words, the image is starting to appear into the user view. And here, what I need to do is get the actual image tag, which is on entry.target. And the next thing I want to do is get the src attribute that is on the data-src. And I can get that using the dataset property, which gives me back an object containing all of the data-attribute as properties. And using the ES6 destructuring syntax to get the data-src. If you're confused about it, I'm just saving this value into a variable name called src. The next thing I want to do is put that value into the real src attribute on the image, and I can do that using the setAttribute method. Unless I want to disconnect the observer because I'm no longer interested in continue watching my image tag because there isn't anything else I want to do with it once it's loaded. This is similar to removing an event handler. Now, let's go back into the browser and see what's happened. I am going to watch the network tab here for the images, and I will add a filter for my ranking image. I will reload the page, and you can see that the image is not being downloaded initially, but as I scroll down, you can see that the request is triggered and the image is downloaded and visible. However, that was really fast. Since the image is not heavy and I am localhost, the load time is pretty good and I don't even notice anything different as I scroll down. But let's simulate a slower network and see what's happened. As I scroll down, you can see that there was an empty placeholder, and then the image suddenly appeared and caused a bit of a jump on the layout. That is not such a good experience, so I will work on improving that on the next video.